Friends, let us discuss today ELT terms. Grammar translation method. It's a way of studying a language that approaches the language first through detailed analysis of its grammar rules, followed by application of this knowledge to the task of translating sentences and text into the target language. It hence views language learning as consisting of little more than memorizing rules and facts in order to understand and manipulate the morphology and syntax of the foreign language. Direct method. Here, mother tongue was avoided, no translation was given, and meanings are conveyed through action and demonstration. It is also called natural method, psychological method, reform method, phonetical method, phonic method, and anti-grammar method. Use of everyday vocabulary and structures are done here. Grammar is taught inductively here. Structural or situational method. It aims to develop oral proficiency in the language through carefully selected vocabulary, which forms a general service list for the learner to use in everyday communication. Here, language teaching begins with the spoken English. Materials are presented orally and practiced in situations. Grammatical items are graded from simple to complex. Here, use of mother tongue is avoided. Communicative language teaching. Communicative language teaching does not look at language as a set of linguistic items for the learner to store them in his memory. It aims to develop communicative competence. Its focus is on meanings and functions rather than on the form of the language. All the four language skills receive equal treatment here. Here, the teaching of targeted language is done in the targeted language. The bilingual method. The bilingual method follows the traditional PPP structure, that means presentation, practice, production. Here, language 1 is used to gloss difficult words and not for translating the whole language as it was done in grammar translation method. Eclectic approach. Using of not any one particular method but includes a mixture of different methods in the class is called eclectic approach. Blended learning. Teacher and student equally involved in learning. It is one-to-one process, especially used in spoken English classes. Here, direct involvement of the teacher is in the classroom. If the teacher is not available, using the media, for example, YouTube and others, is done. It is also called CALL, that means Computer Assisted Language Learning. In India, in Kendriya Vidyalaya, this method is used. Umbrella terms. All the ways of denoting the teaching of English can be bundled together into umbrella terms. There are two famous umbrella terms. The first one is ELT, that means English Language Teaching. It is British umbrella term. The second one is TESOL, Teaching English to the Speakers of Other Language. It is American umbrella term. Ear training. Ear training is an oral comprehension technique in English language teaching. It is not easy to communicate if one can hardly understand what other people are saying. To achieve quick, tangible results in this area, one has to practice a unique oral comprehension method, ear training. It can be achieved by dictation and listening exercises, as both require a complete attention for listening. Basic English. Basic English is an English-based controlled language created by linguist and philosopher Charles K. Ogden as an international auxiliary language and as an aid for teaching English as a second language. It was presented in Ogden's book, Basic English, a general introduction with rules and grammar. Ogden's basic and the concept of a simplified English gained its greatest publicity just after the Allied victory in the Second World War as a means for world peace. Although basic English was not built into a program, similar simplifications have been advised for various international uses. Ogden's associate I.A. Richards promoted its use in schools in China. Thank you, dear friends. See you soon with a new video.